Yo, yo, man. Huh, your culture boy grooving to Lil' Luther. Luther! Oh, this my shit. I ain't gonna lie, I'm fucking with this hard this week. I've been jamming this song damn near the whole week. Y'all got a vibe with me on this one. Ooh. Let's go, dog. We is back. Another episode. We grooving so hard today. Rock that shit, Luther. Let's go. Man, let me chill. Let me chill. Cause Luther been going hard for me this week. I don't know what it is, man. But it's just something about Luther, man. He just been, you know, maybe it's the holidays or something. But anyway, man, I'm back again. And before I yell out what episode this is, I think I'm gonna chill with that. Because sometimes I do so many episodes and I switch them up. Like, I'm like, nah, I'm going to drop that episode after this one. But I didn't already gave the number. So it's like, damn, I didn't already say this episode right here. And then so now I'm not going to say the episode. But look, I'm just back with another episode, back to get more shit off my chest. You know what I'm saying? We in the 150s, that's for sure. I'm going to just do it like that. We in the 150s and stuff like that. But anyway, man, I hope y'all been having a great week. I hope y'all been continuing to fulfill your goals. I hope that y'all been passionate, been consistent. I hope y'all been blessed. I hope y'all been grateful. Your boy is back. But I'm never going to leave anyway. So you're just going to have to get used to it. But anyway, man, like I said, it's the holidays coming up. To be honest with you, man, Christmas is like a low-key fucking money plot, dog. Because you know how America is right now, man. A lot of people don't got money like that. We don't have money to be buying. Unfortunately, all these fucking nieces and nephews we got out here. You know what I'm saying? You got to buy your cousin something. You got to buy your kids something. You got to buy your stepkids stuff. You got to buy your nieces, your uncles, your aunts, mom, dad. Man, people don't got money like that. No, you're looking at like $2,000-$3,000 just on gifts. Man, mortgages is going up, rent is going up, groceries is going up. Man, I'm starting to understand why grandpa and grandma was just giving your boys boxes and socks for Christmas and shit. I'm almost at that stage. I'm almost at that stage of giving my nieces and nephews drawers and socks. Now, probably not my nieces and shit. I'm not finna go shop for like girls' underwear and shit. You know what I'm saying? I might leave that to the wife to do that. But all my male counterparts, all my male cousins and nephews and shit, be prepared to get some fucking drawers and socks for Christmas because it's getting crazy out here, all right? Fuck that. You finna get some Hanes too. You ain't getting no Polo or you're not getting no Ralph Lauren or Tommy Hilfiger. Your ass is getting Hanes, okay? You don't need to be showing your draws anyway like that. So get you some draws and just be happy with that shit because that's where the point that I'm at right now. You know what I'm saying? I don't even know what stage that is. And then grandpa stage, I don't know. Unk stage, unk, you know, I don't know what the fuck it is, but you know what I'm saying? Be prepared. That shit's coming soon. I know this is not the proper glass to sip wine in, but I don't give a shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to step out on my wine type of thing and shit, but I really only like one wine. It's a sweet wine, but I'm trying to get to the more the elegant type of wines. You know, the wines that you only drink with certain kind of food. Like the wines you only sip with like steak, the ones you sip with like fish and shit like that. So I'm gonna try to advance in that and stuff like that. So you know what I'm saying? Just grow with your boy. We gonna make shit happen. Because I wanna go to the restaurants and I wanna be like, what do you want to drink? I'd be like, shit, man, I want some wine. Open that wine menu up and go straight to where I want. So cuz could be like, oh, he know what the fuck he talking. Yes, sir. I do know what the fuck I want. I know what kind of wine I got. I'm a wine connoisseur. So respect the fucking game and go get my wine. But, you know, it'll get there. 2024, that's going to be the goal. But anyway, man, something that I'll be wanting to get off my chest. The antisocial, the introvert in me. Sometimes, you know, sometimes it gets a little frustrating how antisocial or introverting I can be. Because to be honest with you, I don't be acting funny when I get invited to events, birthday parties, even weddings and shit. Like, I don't go to be, I mean, I don't go to, like, you know, disrespect you. Because to be honest with you, like, I'm the most positive person out there, but I just don't fuck with a lot of people. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm positive. Like, I don't have to know you to wish you the best, to wish you success. Just anything positive in your life, man. Like, for sure, dog, do your thing. You know what I'm saying? I salute you to anybody out there. Like, on everything, I want people to be happy. I want them to live the life they want to live. I want them to achieve success. But me personally, I don't rock with a lot of motherfuckers, dog. I don't like being around a lot of people. So when you invite me to a party or an event or something like that, and I don't show up, it's nothing against you. It's because Floyd don't like being around a lot of you motherfuckers. Not you that invited me to the party. But, man, look, it's going to be somebody in there that I'm not going to say I don't like, but I just don't like their vibe. I don't fuck with them for some reason. It's nothing against that person I don't fuck with, dog. I just don't fuck with you. It's nothing against you. It's nothing negative against you. Our vibes just don't match. You know what I'm saying? And that's just life. I ain't gonna like everybody. Everybody ain't gonna like me. But if I don't like you, I don't wish nothing bad on you. I still wish success on you. So when I get invited to certain of these parties and I see some of these pictures, I'd be like, man, yeah, I don't really fuck with that person right there. Like, nothing against that person, but I don't rock with that person. And I can't be myself if I go to your event and it's 3-4 people throughout the party that I see and I'm not comfortable with being around the motherfuckers. I can't be myself. I can't be the chill, Floyd, cool, calm. And it's nothing against you. That's just how I am. So what I will do is I will go up. I will hug you. I will take a picture with you. You know what I'm saying? I will chop it up with you a few minutes. You know what I'm saying? And I might look left and right. And if I see somebody that I know, I might jab them up, chunk them the deuce. And after that, I am fucking gone. 20, 30 minutes, I am in and out. You know, like I said, it's nothing against you. It's all love. But I just don't rock with that motherfucker right there. I don't rock with that person right there. And I can't be myself. I can't be who I want to be. But you know what I will do? I will hit you up and be like, look, hey, bro. Hey, let's go have a brunch, man. Let's go chill, man. Let's go out to, you know, let's do a little breakfast. Let's do a little lunch. Let's do a little dinner. Let's chop it up. You know what I'm saying? What's been up? I do like that one-on-one kind of, like, you know what I'm saying? That one-on-one person-to-person meeting shit like that. You know what I'm saying? That's more my style, you know? I'm not a fucking party type person, dog. I've never been cool with just the big group gathering type things. If I do go to a gathering, I'm finna play the cut. I'm finna play the corner. I'm finna observe and see what's going on. I'ma look over there and see what they doing over there. All right. Yeah. Okay. I'm peeping y'all over there. I'ma look to the right. Okay. All right. Yeah. I see what y'all doing. I'ma look straight. Okay. Yeah. I see y'all over there. I'ma play the cut. That's just me. That's just my style. I got to be aware of what's going on because, like I said, man, you know, man, people got bad intentions and shit. And I'm not being, I can't think of the word right now, but I'm not being all fucking dramatic and all that. But I mean, that's just how I am. Like I said, there's no disrespect to you, but I just don't rock with a lot of motherfuckers if y'all invite me to a party. So don't even invite me to a party. If y'all want to invite me somewhere, invite me to like a little brunch or something. Like, hey, man, let's discuss some business. You want to go for a brunch? Want to go for some coffee or something like that? Yeah, I went that. You know, But Florida's not the party type. Florida's not. I might pass by them. I might play the parking lot. I might pass through that. I might parking lot pimp that motherfucker. I'm not going in. You might see me outside. Oh, yeah, Florida. I seen him pass through. He didn't come in. Nah, he didn't come in. He passed by, though. That's me. Yeah, he passed by, but he didn't come. Oh, damn, man. What's up with that? Y'all know how he is. And like I said, man, I'm not mad at nobody. I'm not hating on nobody. I don't hate on nobody regardless, but I don't hate nobody. But I'm not mad at nobody. And it's just like when I say I just don't rock with a lot of people. I don't rock with big crowds and shit like that. Because I don't know people. People are shady out there. People are scandalous out there. People be hating out there. People don't have good intentions out there. People are not positive. People are not chill. Some people are loud. They're disrespectful. I don't like that. So I just rather just chill with my own company, my own little crowd, my own little circle. Or if I chill with you, it might be one-on-one type thing. That's how we going to do it. You know, and like I said, I'm not mad at nobody. I hope nobody's not mad at me, because to be honest with you, if you mad at me, if you hating on me, man, I'ma pray for you. I'ma pray for you, because to be honest with you, if you mad and you hating on me, the reason why I'm gonna pray for you, because you're wasting time on what you need to do in life by hating on me, by hating on anybody. You're wasting all that time hating on somebody when you can be out there knocking out the shit you need to do. It's wasted energy. It's raggedy energy. You hating on somebody, doing all this hating, you can be doing the shit that you need to do. Successful people really don't have no time to be hating on no motherfucker, dog. They trying to get to what y'all say, the bag, you know? Or they're trying to fulfill a goal or complete something, whatever it is. They don't have the time and the energy to be wasting on hating on somebody, to even think about hating on somebody. Like, man, we gotta chill with that. And I hate when people be on social media and be like, oh, y'all always think somebody hating on y'all. Motherfuckers do be hating. What the hell are you talking about? Dog, I could post positive quotes every day and somebody's gonna be like, man, this motherfucker always posting positive quotes and all that, fake positive and all that, you know. And, you know, somebody's going to knock you, dog. That's just how the world is. That's how the world is. Motherfuckers is, everybody is not going to like you. Y'all need to understand that. But at the same time, y'all need to understand that people is not going to like y'all, but y'all going to continue to turn up. You finna continue to take flights. You finna continue to take trips. You finna continue to hit that parking lot, knock off that whip. You gonna continue to buy that real estate. You gonna continue to pop them tags. You gonna continue to eat at that 4 or 5 star dining. You gonna continue to get that top floor with that top view. That's what it's all about, bro. It's all about living life and just doing your thing. Stop letting people think that living life is not cool. Living life is great. Life is awesome. Get your money, travel, live life. It is awesome, bro. Sis, it's a big world out there. The water is blue. What Beyonce say? And the water so blue. Yo, man, life is great. Look, to all my people out there that's going through depression, that's going through financial situations, that's going through a loss, man, my prayers is going to y'all. My prayers is going to y'all, man. I pray that y'all get through that storm. I pray that y'all overcome what y'all are going through. And when y'all do overcome it, man, y'all gonna be stronger. Y'all gonna be resilient. It feels good to cross that finish line, because sometimes, you know what I'm saying, when you run that marathon, when you run that race, you know that finish line, that shit look far. But if you keep going, if you don't stop, you get closer and closer to that end goal, which is the finish line and shit. Now, you might have all kind of distractions. You might have motherfuckers hating left, right. You might have a pothole you might have to jump over. You might have people tugging on you, all that shit like that. But you got to just stay focused with the tunnel vision, man. Fuck all that bullshit. Because at the end of the day, you matter. Your goals matter. Your kids matter. Your finances matter. It's all about you, man. Like, on everything. Like, man, this is a cold world, man. This world ain't fair. And a lot of people got to understand that, too. This world is not fair. But if you grind, if you do what you want to do in life, you can turn the odds to your favor on everything. The motherfuckers hating on you, man, you could turn the odds on them. Use that shit for motivation, man. I want somebody to hate on me because that is going to motivate me. When I feel like man, fuck this. I just think about a motherfucker hating me. It don't even have to be nobody hating me. I'm just throwing it out there like somebody hating on you right now, thinking that you're going to do it. And that right there is going to motivate me to do what the hell I want to do. It's going to get me out of bed. It's kind of like when you want to go to the gym and you wake up and you're like, ah, I don't feel like going to the gym today, dog. I don't feel like going out. But then you know the end goal is like, man, summertime, I said, I'm finna be ready. You can't be summertime ready if you keep pushing the shit, if you go back in the bed. So you just got to keep pushing yourself. You just got to keep motivating yourself. I wasn't really trying to turn this to no fucking motivational ass podcast and shit, because that's not me. Because I cuss too much. And I do a lot of things. I'm not trying to be no motivational ass podcaster. Yeah, man, but you just got to allow life to be amazing, dog, on everything. Shit is wild. I'm not even going to lie. I almost wanted to end this episode. I said I was going to do a quick episode because I had to go to the grocery store and I got to get groceries because, man, I've been working some long hours and I'm tired of going eat fast food or some takeout. I need a home-cooked meal. Wifey, she been working too. So when we get off, it's late and ain't nobody trying to cook late. But the only thing that I hate when I go grocery shopping is around this time of year, you have those Salvation Army people that's out there ringing a bell. And them motherfuckers is scandalous, bro. Like, I hate, like, we're like, Merry Christmas. Would you like to donate? And you got to make up like, hey, if I give some cash, I'm gonna throw it in a pot. But you know what I learned? Dog, I don't know if they actually keep that money. I don't know if they donate that money. Because I remember one time I was going into the store and they was picking up the people that was, you know what I'm saying, the Salvation Army people. And I remember, excuse me, this wine is, yeah. But I remember a lady was like, let's go get some cigarettes. And then she said, how much money did you make today? And I forgot the other part because I'm not trying to lie to you. I forgot the number he said, but she was like, all right, let's go get some cigarettes. And I was like, oh, damn. Y'all using the Salvation Army money to go get some cigarettes? I was like, oh, well, fuck that. I ain't finna get y'all no money ever again. Y'all didn't lose my support because I used to always get change and dump it in there and be like, yo, Merry Christmas, dog. I was just contributing to a motherfucker habit. I was contributing to somebody's fucking addiction. I don't know what that addiction was, but I think I contributed to a lot of people's addiction. That's and people on the side of the road. I used to always get money too. I used to look in a little, you know what I'm saying, a little cup holder, have some change in there and give it to them. Until I had this guy working on my car, and one of his friends was a bum. I don't know if that's the proper term, but I'm going to say he was a bum, but he was begging for some money on the corner. And then he said, man, we almost got arrested. And he was like, what y'all was doing? And he was like, man, we was out there and we was getting some money and the police pulled over. He was out there panhandling for some money and police pulled over. And he said, but he let us go. And he was like, well, we got some money to get some beer, man. You want some? And the guy that was working on my car, he was like, nah. And I'm thinking like, man, that's what y'all motherfuckers do. Y'all out there panhandling in for beer and cigarettes and all kind of drugs, man. And I've been out here just willingly giving you my change, thinking like, oh, man, I'm helping somebody. I'm really helping you to get drunk. I'm helping you to, you know what I'm saying, smoke that cigarette. I'm helping you to get high, pop that pill, needle. I don't know what the fuck y'all do these days. I'm so out the loop. But I've been helping contribute to an addiction. And I don't know if that, I don't know how to feel about that. I was blessing somebody addiction. That's crazy. So people that's homeless, that's out there begging for money, y'all just lost me. Y'all just lost a good client in me. And let me ask you one, let me tell you one thing. So me and a friend of mine, Thanksgiving Eve, we went out and we fed the homeless. It was a lady on a corner sitting down at the light, and she was panhandling because when we pulled up on her, we was like, hey, hey. And she was like, hold on for a second. She was going up to a car to get some money. So she came back. She was like, hey, what's up? I said, we was like, hey, we're passing out Thanksgiving dinners and stuff like that. Do you want one? And she was like, nah. And we was like, nah, it's for free. You know what I'm saying? We're passing out meals to the homeless and stuff. And I don't know if that disrespected her, but she was like, I'm not homeless. And we was like, okay, but do you want a meal? Because we're feeding people. And she was like, no, I'm okay. And she's like, do y'all have any drink? We was like, yeah, we got soda. She was like, I'll take a soda. But I was thinking, like, if you're not homeless, which you probably not might, you might not be homeless, but why are you on the corner begging people for change? And that right there lets me know that people on the corner, I'm not saying all of them, they're not out there for food. They're out there for money to supply their habit. It is a high likely chance that if you give somebody some money that's standing at the light, that's holding up one of them signs, they're not going to get no food. They're going to satisfy their drug habit. It's been plenty of times where they, and I'm not going to say the dumb ones. I don't want to call nobody dumb. But if you're standing at the light and it's a restaurant behind you like McDonald's, Burger King, Taco Bell, and somebody says, hey, I don't got no cash on me, but I'll buy you something to eat. And then they be like, nah, that's okay. Man, this world's grimy, bro. This world's shady, man. Sometimes you got to be heartless, man. You know what I'm saying? Because, like, you know what I'm saying? The evil, they be trying to eat up on the positive people out there, man. The good-hearted people, man. They try to take advantage of a lot of good-hearted people out there. So all my good-hearted people, just be aware, man. And sometimes you have to say no. Sometimes you have to look at those people and you got to keep going because you got to understand that they are really trying to take advantage of you. It's very unfortunate out there, but a lot of the cases that shit happens. But yeah, man. Again, before I get out of here, anybody that is going through something, man, I'm praying for you. And anybody who watches this show, man, that watches this podcast, that's been sharing it, that's comments on it, that likes it, thank you. I appreciate you. I am very humble. I'm very grateful that you're watching this, that you're watching me. And hopefully you can relate to some of the shit that I said. Hopefully you can agree. But if you disagree, that's cool too. You know what I'm saying? You have your rightfully so to do that. But until then, man, I'm going to see y'all. Y'all be safe out there. Y'all be blessed. And y'all be grateful. All right, man. This is the Kickback. This your boy, North End Floyd, man. All right. I'll see y'all soon. 100.